Hello, I'm Dr. Andrew Neville. I specialize in treating adrenal fatigue and related chronic illnesses. The chronic illness I want to talk about today is your sleep problems, insomnia, trouble getting to sleep, trouble staying asleep, being a light sleeper, that kind of a thing. The vast majority of my patients with adrenal fatigue have sleep issues. And they'll tell me, "Doc, if I could just sleep, my adrenal fatigue would heal and go away." I say, yes, that's partially true. But in order to fix your sleep, we're going to have to fix your adrenal fatigue. That's the problem. So why does the sleep get disturbed, right? What's the problem here? And it's multifactorial for the majority of patients, right? And almost all of those factors are wired to your stress response system, right? AKA adrenal fatigue. When the body is in a stress response, we are kicked into what we call fight or flight, and we suppress rest and digest, right? So what happens when that happens? We're dumping stress hormone. Well, that stress hormone floats around and goes everywhere, and it causes specific damage itself, but it also causes a metabolic shift that can cause some damage as well. That shift increases free radical production, oxidative stress, stuff like that. These free radicals are like little pinballs in an old pinball machine, bouncing around, nicking things, damaging things. And that damage exists in the blood. And since the blood goes everywhere, the damage is everywhere. So what happens? You're in a stress response. You've got high cortisols, right? Cortisol goes into the brain and causes damage. Cortisol, adrenaline, the free radicals, all that causes damage. The architecture of your sleep, so the main kind of neurobiological mechanisms of your sleep, is deep in a central part of your brain called the limbic system. There's a piece of the limbic system called the hippocampus, which is where the primary circuitry is. It gets damaged. It actually atrophies. That's seen MRI studies with regard to this. It gets damaged. So when you damage that neural circuitry, you can cause problems with sleep. What else happens? Well, your circadian rhythm, right, it's defined by your limbic system telling your HPA axis to dump cortisol in the morning, get you up and animated, ready to tackle your day. And then it gradually goes down throughout the rest of the day. It should be at its lowest level when the sun goes down and you're ready for bed and then you go to sleep, right? Well, with chronic stress over time, that mechanism gets messed up. The cortisols are high in the beginning, the cortisols are low, the cortisols are erratic. One of the most common patterns we'll see when we test people with salivary cortisol levels is that the morning comes down and the evening goes up. Now you got daytime cortisol in the evening. Daytime cortisol in the evening. I mean, you're not going to sleep, right? You're not going to sleep. What else happens? This suppresses serotonin production, right? Which is why everybody throws serotonin stuff, tryptophan and 5-HTP, which does have some benefit. Suppresses melatonin production as well, which of course melatonin helps with the onset of sleep. Now, what conventional medicine will do is they'll look at the symptoms that come about from excess wear and tear, right? When we're in stress physiology, there's a set of symptoms. I've talked about them before. Insomnia is one of them. You can cover that up. You can knock people out. You know, give them a hypnotic, like, you know, Lunesta, Ambien, give them a benzodiazepine, Xanax, Valium, whatever, and you cover it up. You might even get them to sleep. Might, and I say might because it's not a slam dunk, right? And I'm sure you've, a lot of you have tried these things and know it's not a slam dunk. When you cover that symptom up, you might not feel the symptom anymore, but you've not fixed the underlying problem. And this is an issue, and it's a big issue. Because this physiology is still there. Just because you're sleeping or knocked out, really, just because you're knocked out doesn't mean you fix this. And this pattern, this damage continues to happen. It's not until we fix this that the sleep fully normalizes. So there's other problems with those medications. You probably know that as well as I do, whether it's tolerance and side effect and needing more and more and actually inhibiting the deeper stages of sleep. So you might sleep, but you don't get the restorative benefit of sleep. So then you go to alternative medicine and they're like, oh, well, take 5-HTP or St. John's wort or take some melatonin. And they're a little hit or miss, those things. They're okay, right? But they're hit or miss because you don't know what the actual pathophysiology, what the problem with that each individual sleep cycle is, right? If you're not sleeping because 100% because you don't have any melatonin anymore and you give melatonin, you're going to sleep and it's going to be good. And that works sometimes, right? But most people are not 100% of one serotonin or melatonin or whatever. It's a combination. It's 10% of this, 10% of this, 10% of this, 10% of this. What we need to do primarily is shift the body out of fight or flight, turn on the healing and repair. Remember, you can take all the fancy supplements and herbs that you want, but the body's not going to utilize those and not going to truly heal until we turn on your body's healing energy, right? So we want to shift this physiology. You need to use some things to help to actually fix the hippocampal damage in the limbic system where the sleep architecture starts, right? Do that, control the cortisol, adrenaline, gradually get people to sleep. And yes, you need to sleep to be able to heal and restore for sure. But in order to get to the sleep, we've got to go through this stress response system, balance that out, and little by little by little, your sleep will gradually improve, right? Get to sleep earlier, stay asleep, sleep more deeply over time. It absolutely can happen. I don't care if it's been going on for, you know, 1 year, 10 years, a couple of decades. You can fix that and you need to fix that, but you have to treat the underlying cause. You have to treat this trigger-happy stress response system that has got you stuck. That's the focus, all right? I hope this helps. I know the information is a little different. If you need any other explanations about adrenal fatigue or stress or these kinds of things, just click on the link below. Go to my site, check out more videos, that kind of a thing, okay? I wish you all the best.